Hello everyone, welcome to the next session of our course Internet Fundamentals and Web Tools. So, this is the 31st session. In this session, we are going to discuss more about email. Like in our previous session, we just started with some introduction about email. So, what is an email and what are the parts of email addresses? So, how to obtain email address from starting of how to obtain email address, we'll start this today's session. So, in our previous session, we have seen what is an email and what is the significance of email and what are the parts of email address we have seen. So, and there are few things which we need to send an email address to send an email to another person. That means, so those are our email and recipient email address. And the account in our email, I mean, there should be an account in one of the email servers and also the internet connection. So, we will discuss with like how to obtain the email address and what are the email clients, like what are the web email clients and what are desktop clients. We are going to see some examples of desktop clients and also the web email clients, and then what are the mail folders, like what are the different types of mail folders will be there, like if an email comes, where will it store? If we send an email, where will it store? So, these are the things which we will see, and also what are the components of the email message. So, these are the things that we are going to see in this session. So, how to obtain the email address? So, one needs an email server in order to send or receive an email. You can pay an account, you can pay for an account through ISP such as AOL, or we can get it from any free service. So, email address can be given by organization where the person is working, and we can get the free email accounts from yahoomail.com, gmail.com, rediffmail.com, hotmail.com, and we are going to see something with Gmail, like how we will obtain an email address with Gmail, we are going to see. So, one needs an email address, email server in order to send or receive an email. So, what is an email server means is, email server is the one which will provide accounts to the users, like suppose I want to send an email or I want to receive an email, I need an email address. So, email server is the one who will give account or who will provide email address to the users. So, that email address will be protected by password. So, every email address or every user will have their own account, that means will have their own email address and password. So, this will be provided by email server. So, the examples of email server are like Yahoo Mail and Gmail or Rediff Mail. So, these are the some of the free email accounts, or we can get the paid email, any organization if we are working for, then they might provide one email address to the employees for their personal, for their use, like for their office use. So, suppose one employee is working here in India and another employee is working somewhere in Singapore. So, they can exchange the mails in order to communicate formally. So, email communication is one of the formal communications in lot of organizations. So, if a person sends an email to other person, then he is formally communicating. Suppose a person just calls another employee and spoke something about his projects and deadlines, and if he committed for something, then it is not a formal communication. I mean, later he can say that no, I was meaning this and all, but if email communication is formal, if he can actually commit some date and stick to it if it is communicated over an email. So, that is an importance of email communication in an organization. So, and where can we get these email accounts from? So, a lot of individual users, like not working in the offices, or people who are working in the offices will have their official email accounts or office email accounts, but usually personal email accounts are usually free. So, they will be provided by Yahoo, Gmail, Rediff Mail or Hotmail. So, all these and there are lot more providers available to provide email address. So, how we will get an email address, we are going to see with Gmail. So, let us open the browser and we will access, we will try to create one Gmail address. So, how we will open the browser, like here is an Internet Explorer button. So, just click it, this is Microsoft Edge. So, I am going to type in www.gmail.com, so which is the URL for, so it is already being loaded. So what I am going to do is I will see if there is any other browser available. Let me open Google Chrome. gmail.com will open. So if there is already an account being opened, what we will do, we are going to we can go to private browsing in order to invalidate all these cookies. So we have seen this earlier, but I am going to show it again. Go to settings, new incognito window. Then here I am going to open Gmail. So Gmail is one of the popular email servers. So this will be this will provide the email accounts for free. So right now let us assume that we don't have any email address. So I'm clicking more options, and here we have two options like not your device or create account. So I'm going to click create account. So I already have an account, but we already have one account, but I'm just demonstrating how we will get an email address. So we are going to provide some name here like APSSDC and first name and last name. So I'm going to say manatv and username. So this is the username or the email address that the people will be communicating with us. So we should be very careful in giving this email address. So it should be possibly unique. So it can, I mean, no other person can have the same email address. So suppose if we give APSSDC, then nobody else in the world will be having APSSDC@gmail.com. So what I am going to do is APSSDC, usually it will be first name dot last name. So I am going to give APSSDC.manatv. So if somebody want to communicate with us, then they will send a mail to APSSDC.manatv@gmail.com, and password. So this password is also very important, and with this password only we will be able to log into the email server, or email we will be able to access the emails. So right now I'm giving a password, I'm giving some password, and if you see here, as we are typing the password, it is showing just dot symbols. But it is not whatever we type in the password password fields, it will just show us dots, because the password cannot be disclosed or password cannot be shown to others. Suppose in front of others we are opening an if we are opening our mail ID or if we are opening our mail account, then if it is just clear text like whatever we type, if it is showing, then it is very easy for them to, I mean, the other person will also know our password, so which is not the good case. So usually passwords will be shown as dots or star symbols, asterisk symbols it will be showing, and select whatever the date of birth. So I am just selecting some random date of birth and gender, and then just we need to give the phone number, and then next step, then we need to accept the privacy policy. So every when we are creating any mail account, we need to accept some terms and conditions of that email. So now we are going to there are lots of privacy policies which we need to agree if we need to access Gmail. So we are going to read all these things and then press I agree. Then it is saying verify your account. So we need to give our mobile number or phone number to verify this account, or any we need to either have a mobile number or we need to have a valid email address. So right now we cannot give any mobile address because we don't have any mobile phone, but we have an account already just for demonstration. So if we just give the account name, mobile phone number, then click continue, we will be receiving one account, we will be receiving one code, like just say we will be receiving an SMS with a code like 1234 or whatever the number. So that number we need to enter again in our web page, then our email account will be created. So what I am going to do is, without all those things, we already have an email account which I created, so and saved here. So this one I am going to use www.gmail.com. If I just open, then it will ask for. So now we have, let us assume we did all those things and created an email. So this is how we can log in. So this is the email ID I created, apssdctemp@gmail.com, then click next and enter your password. So whatever the password that we have said, then we need to enter here. Most of the times this is like a recovery email and all, but we do not want to do all those things. So this is how we can actually obtain an email address. So let us assume we logged in here and we obtained an email address. So we'll see it, we'll come back and look at this again later. So this is how we can obtain the email address. And email clients, let's see. So an email client is a program used to manage your email. So email clients allow you to send, receive email, among other things. There are many different email clients you can choose from, some of which are free to use. So there are two types of email clients available, which are webmail clients and desktop clients. So email client is a program used to manage our emails. So that means we should be able to send mails or receive mails, and we should be able to organize the mails. So this mail is from so and so person, this mail is from so and so person, this mail is having higher importance, this mail is having lower importance. So we will be receiving mails. We need a software to view the mails and read the mails, get the mails, and send the mails, reply to different mails, and for all these things, or delete the mails. So for all these things we need some software. So that software is called email clients. So this email, why we are calling email client, is we have an email server and we are accessing it from the server. So our program is called email client. So the client always requests the server to get the information. So here we are requesting the emails from the server. So we are email client, and the server name is email server. And there are many different kind of emails you can choose from, but some of which are free. So which we have just seen, the Gmail is one of the free servers which is available. And there are two types of email clients available. One is webmail and another is desktop mail. So webmail, and we are going to see what is a webmail and desktop mail. So webmail is something which we can access through web, and desktop client is something which will be staying in our computer. Like we have to install that in our computer and open it up and access the mails. So with webmail, we read send mails through web browser and webmail interface. We can open webmail clients only when the internet connection is active, no offline access. So all the mail management will be done inside the browser. Examples: Yahoo, Google, Rediff supports webmail clients. Okay, with the webmail we can read, or we can we read send emails through web browser or on the webmail interface. So whatever that we have accessed just now is the webmail. That means suppose Gmail web client that we have accessed. That means what does that mean is, in web browser we need to type in the URL of the web server, then this mail opens up. Then what will happen, like we have to provide our email address and password, then it will open up another UI interface, another user interface, which is denoting, okay, these are all the mails that you have got, and these are all the mails that you have sent, and these are all the this is how your mails are organized. These are all star mails, that means more important mail, these are important mails, and these are all the tasks that you wanted to that you need to access. So like this, a page will be, a web page will be opened. So we know what is a web page. Web page is the page which is shown by web browser. So the interface of the web page is about the mails. So it will show all the mails that we have got, and we can open the webmail clients whenever in the internet connection is active. That means browser, if we type in some URL and send it, then it will try to access that particular server and get the information. That means if there is no server, that means if there is no internet connection, we cannot access that mail. So there will be no offline access. Offline access is without internet connection, we cannot access the mail, and all the mail management will be done inside the browser. So all the mail management, whatever the mails that we receive, receiving, reading the mails and replying to mails, deleting the mails, moving the mails from one folder to another folder, everything will be done in the web browser itself. So we don't have any special software for that. In the browser itself, we have to manage our mails. So example is Google Rediff supports webmail clients. So just now we opened a webmail client. So we'll open that once again. www.gmail.com, because we already logged in, it should be opening directly. So this is how a webmail client look like. So this is the mail that we have got, Andy from Google APSSDC. So this is our name, APSSDC, get more out of your Google account. So this is the first mail that we have got. So this is the mail, and we can read this mail, and there are different options like archive this mail, report spam. We'll see this report spam later, but we can actually delete the mail and move the mail. So this is how we can access the mails using web client. So it is only about accessing. How to send a mail, we'll see later. So again, we will go to desktop email client. So an application that runs on our personal computer or workstation and enables you to send, receive and organize email. So it is called a client because email system are based on client server architecture. So one mail account can have many clients associated with it. So mail is sent from many clients to a central server, which reroutes the mail to its intended destination. So mails can be read and composed offline, that is when the internet connection is inactive. So an application that runs on our personal computer or workstation that enables you to send, receive and organize the mails. So this is a special software installed on our computer, or either on our it may be our smartphone, laptop or any iPad or any desktop. So this is an email, this is a software installed on our computer. It is not something that we open in browser. So browser itself is a software which is installed on our computer, which will work for many different ways other than email clients. But desktop email clients are specifically meant for mailing purpose. So we can use these desktop email clients only for accessing the mails. So we can read the mails, we can reply the mails, we can store the mails also. So it is called client because email systems are based on client server architecture. So this software is the client, and it will contact the email server to get the information about mails. So it will get the emails from email server. So that is why it is email client, or so that's why we'll call it as client. So one mail account have many clients associated with it. So that means suppose we created a Gmail account. So for that, we can access it from our mobile phone. So mobile phone will have a email client software. So and configure this Gmail in that. So we can access in mobile also, and in our laptop also, and in our suppose we have 2-3 different laptops or desktops. Suppose we may be having a laptop and a desktop at home. So everywhere there can be one client for the same mail account. So one account can have many desktop email clients. So mail is sent from many clients to a central server, which reroutes the mail to its intended destination. That means from all these email clients, we have only one account, but different clients are available to access it. Suppose we have the email client installed on our computer, and our Gmail account is configured to it. But we can send mail from web client, which is a web interface, and either we send from web interface or the email client, email client, I mean desktop client, it will go to the same central server, and then it will reroute from there to the intended destination. It will check the recipient's email address, and wherever the recipient email address is, it will try to send the email to that particular domain name or the host name. So it will reroute like that. And mails can be read and composed offline with desktop email clients. So desktop email clients, based on our settings, we can download all the mails at once. So if whenever the internet connection is active, it will download all the mails and save it in our desktop email client. And even if the internet connection is down, we can actually access those mails, open those mails and check it. Even compose the reply. Like we can type in the reply and keep it ready for sending. So whenever the internet connection is active, we can send the mail. So it is only when the internet connection is inactive, we can read the mail. I mean, we can read already the existing mail. Suppose some 2 days back we received a mail and we would like to open it now. Using web client, we cannot open because it always depends on the internet connection. So when the internet connection is not there, we cannot access. But whenever the web client is whenever the desktop email client is there, it would already be downloaded and stored in our laptop or in the software. So we can just open the mail and read it, and we can reply the mail, like we can compose the reply or we can compose the email. So we can just type in all the details that we want to send and keep it ready. So whenever the internet connection is active, we can just send that mail. So the internet connection is active, the sending and receiving is possible. Only reading and composing we can do offline. So this is how an email client works. So here in the diagram, imagine that this is our email is composed here in the laptop. So email is composed in a mail client, and then it will go to SMTP server or the email server. So once it reaches the email server, depending on the suppose we are sending from Gmail to some other username at yahoo.com, then it will find that yahoo.com's DNS server, it will find the yahoo.com's IP address in DNS server, and it will go to the internet and it will get that yahoo.com domain name, and then it will find the email user account of that yahoo.com username, and it will send it. So finally the recipient will get the mail, like the recipient. So wherever we are sending, like username at yahoo.com, that particular email address will be found, and if there is any email client associated with that email account, it will be reached there like this. So right now we discussed about this right from this laptop to the SMTP server, and this SMTP server do lot of things to send the email to the destination. And So what are the popular desktop email clients? We can just see here. One is Microsoft Outlook, and Apple Mail, IBM Notes, Mozilla Thunderbird, Jimbra, and lot of my email clients are there. So most famous one is Microsoft Outlook, which comes with Microsoft Office. And if you are using Safari or Mac OS, then Apple Mail is one of the famous one. And IBM Notes. So IBM Notes is also one of the famous mail clients, and Mozilla Thunderbird. So this is Mozilla Thunderbird and Jimbra are the free email clients. So others are like we have to pay something to get those emails. But Mozilla Thunderbird is especially for Windows operating systems and also the Linux operating systems, it is free of cost. Like even Jimbra is also, we can just download it from the internet and can start using it right away. So these are the popular email clients, whereas others are like a bit costly. Others we have to pay some money to download those softwares. So we will see how to configure an email client in Mozilla Thunderbird now. Okay, so here we are going to we already have a mail account. And we will see how we can open an email. We have already seen how we can open an email client in browser. And right now we will configure the desktop email client. So right now we have one software called Mozilla Thunderbird. So here it is there. So I'm going to open this. We can download it from Mozilla Thunderbird software. Just search for Mozilla Thunderbird and then go here, download. Yeah, we can actually download. It is free, free of, it is, it's a software which is free, so we can download and can use it. So, Mozilla Thunderbird looks like this. I am going to add, Alt T will take me to tools and then go to account settings. Then here there are some, there is an option to add an account actions, and click add mail account. There are other accounts like chart account, feed account and other accounts and all. So, just clicking add account. So, here first name and last name, what is the name it should be, APSSDC, I am just giving, and email address. So, our email address I am just giving, password, then click continue. So, it is trying to configure. So, we will talk about this IMAP and POP3 protocols later, but just we need to understand, we need one of these two things, IMAP settings or POP3 settings for configuring a mail account with desktop web client, desktop mail client. For most of the things, for most of the mail accounts, the settings would have already been there. Here for Gmail also, the setting would have already been there, like incoming mail is, mail will come from imap.gmail.com, outgoing mail will go from smtp.gmail.com, and this is our username. So, I am just saying done. So, it is checking the password and everything, and it is ok. So, now I can say ok. Then you can see the mail has been added here, like apssdctemp@gmail.com. So, to receive the mail, I am just clicking on inbox, so that here you can see apssdctemp@gmail.com connecting to imap.gmail.com. We may have to wait for a bit to check if the mail is received. See, it is showing lot of other things also. So, here it is a Gmail, it has drafts, sent mail, all mails, spam, trash, important, starred, all these things. In that, in the inbox, we have already seen whatever, there is a mail in our inbox, in through web client we have seen this mail. So, I am just clicking this mail. So, here is a reading pane down. So, the same mail is being shown here. If we double click this, then it is showing the email in full format. So, we can just show remote content, then it will start downloading the images also. So, this is the same mail. So, if we open this in this is the same mail in the browser. So, it is the same mail in the web client, and the same mail is in the desktop client. So, this is how we can access the emails from web client and desktop client. So, this is how we can, the configuring actually for Gmail, it is Gmail, Yahoo mail and few other mail accounts, it is relatively easy, because the IMAP and POP3 settings already are known by the email client software, but for other mail accounts we will have to figure out, like we will have to search for what is the POP3 email settings or IMAP settings. We need to IMAP incoming server settings and IMAP outgoing server settings, we need to see and configure those things in the web in the desktop client, then only we can actually open. So, when we discuss IMAP and POP3, we will see what are the server settings that are already present in the Mozilla Thunderbird software. We are going to see in that slide, ok. And then the mail folders. So what are the mail folders? So inbox, inbox, new messages as well as the messages that have been read. So they will, and outbox, the messages not yet sent, and sent items, messages that have been sent, so moved here from outbox, and deleted items, messages deleted from any folder, custom folders, additional folders created by the user, and junk items, some advertisements, promotional mails, etc., like spam. So inbox is the mail folder which where we will be getting all the new mails, or it is not only for the new mails already. Suppose we received a mail and we read it, then it will be, it will also stay in inbox unless we move it to any different folder. So outbox are the messages which are not sent. That means we composed a message and we have not yet sent it. We sent it, but it is not yet sent. From, I mean, we clicked send button, but we did it did not go to the the recipient, or it did not go to the mail server. Suppose we are having a web client and web server, so web server will be somewhere else. We composed a mail and we click send button, that mail will go, but that mail we expect it to go, but it will take some time from the client to the server to send that mail. So in between this, like by the from the time the client starts sending the mail to the server, so there is a time gap. So in this time gap, it will be there in the outbox. Or if there is no internet connection, even if we send, it will say okay, I will send it, but it will still stay in the, it will keep the mail in the outbox. And whenever the internet connection is active, then it will try to it will try to send from our computer. So this is the use of the outbox. So outbox is used to save the mails which are, which user will user thinks that user assumes to be sending the mail, but the web client, because of the unavailability of the internet connection or because of some reason, it is not able to send, or it is in the process of sending. So during this period, it will save the mail into outbox. So if we don't receive, or if the recipient did not receive the mail, first thing we need to check is the outbox. So we composed a mail and we assume it is sent. So we call our friend, yeah, I sent some information over the mail, but if he does not receive it, then we have to check the outbox. Okay, and sent items. So sent items are the items which are already sent. So we, whatever the item, whatever the mails that we have sent, so they will be saved in the sent items. And deleted items. Deleted items are some in some mail accounts, it is called a trash or deleted items, or in maybe there might be any other name. So it will be saved in deleted items. So whatever we delete, so they will not be immediately deleted. It is like the delete button, delete of deleting the files in our personal computer. So whenever we delete, it will be saved in, it will just move it to trash. So if we delete a file, it will be moved to trash. So whenever we click empty trash, then only it will delete all the items of the trash. So deleted items are also like that. But these deleted items, there will be a time gap for every email server. So some email servers will delete the emails which are there in deleted items for the past 30 days. Suppose we deleted now, and tomorrow we thought, okay, accidentally I deleted that mail, I would have got that mail. Then we can go to deleted items and restore it back to inbox or any other folder. But after 30 days or 60 days, then it will slowly, so whatever the mails which are deleted 30 days ago or 60 days ago, the email server automatically deletes the old mails in the deleted items only, not in any other folder, only in deleted items. And custom folders. Custom folders like additional folders created by the user. So apart from inbox and outbox and sent items, deleted items, we can, customer or the user can create lot of folders depending on his need. Like a person will be having different contacts, like all his materials will be, if he is communicating with his classmates, one kind of material will be coming, and if he is if there is some information about his project, then other kind of information, another set of people will be sending. So we can organize the mails, okay, this kind of mails in this folder, or banks will be sending different mails, like okay, your account balance is this, and your credit card balance is this, and a person may be having too many different bank accounts, like Citibank, ICICI Bank, and suppose 3-4 bank accounts are there. We can organize the mails, okay, the mails which are received from Citibank should go here, the mails which are received from ICICI Bank should go here. The mails which you received from IRCTC, like the train ticket reservations, should go here. Something like that. One can organize the mails. So we can create more and more folders to organize all these things. And so those are called custom folders, where we can name them whatever we want. And junk items or the bulk items we will call, or the spam simply we will call. So the spam items are usually the advertisements or promotional mails which people who are trying to cheat us will send some mails for cyber crimes. So these are all called spams. So these if the mail spam filter will if the spam filter think that the suppose a particular mail is an advertisement or some other mail, then it will move to junk items or the spam items. So this is about mail folders. So we are going to see about mail folders and other items, how do we send a mail and what is the structure of an email. So we are going to see all these things in our next session. Thank you.